Hi, I'm Dr. Nicole Vane, the owner of Moonlight Beach Dental, integrative and holistic dentistry. And one of the things I wanted to talk to today is the top 10 things you need to look for in a mercury removal office. One of the things that's made me so passionate about it is that I myself tested positive for being in the 95th percentile of mercury toxicity. So I'm really passionate about the way and the technique that it's done so that I can properly inform my patients and also take them through the correct way of having their mercury removed safely. The first thing that you should ask is, are they certified by the Huggins protocol? Hal Huggins was the pioneer in mercury removal in the early 1980s, and his techniques have held through today on the protocols for safety. The second thing to ask your mercury removal dentist is, what sequence are they going to use to safely remove the mercury fillings? If someone is certified in the Hal Huggins protocol, they're going to have something called a readometer. There's something called an electrogalvanic current that's given off by the mercury and some of the other metals that are in the filling. And what this does is, this is a little device that'll measure the current, and it's placed onto the tooth, and we record the reading on every single mercury filling that's in your mouth. The fillings with the highest negative charge will be ones that are removed first. Those are the most toxic. And then we'll follow down through in the removal sequence, ending on the least toxic fillings last. The third thing you're going to want to ask your doctor before you have any mercury removal done is, how do they test for the mercury levels that are already in your system? I took the test myself. I've never had a mercury filling done, and I was shocked to learn that I was in the 95th percentile for toxicity just from having been around mercury daily in the office. The test that we use here is called the mercury tri-test. It's done by Quicksilver, and what they do is they take a sample of your blood, your urine, and your hair. You send off the kit through the mail, and within about 2 weeks, you'll get your baseline levels of mercury. It's very accurate, and it's also a really great way to see how toxic your mercury fillings are making you. The fourth thing that you want to ask your mercury removal dentist is, what academies are they in? The first one is the IAOMT, the International Academy of Oral Medicine and Toxicology. The other is being a member of the Huggins Group training. The third is the IABDM, the International Academy of Biologic Medicine and Dentistry. And the fourth and last one is the Holistic Dental Association. And you'll want to look for those certifications hanging in their waiting room as well as on their website. Number 5 and 6. These are really, really, really important things to look for in a mercury removal dentist. One is, do they have an external mercury vacuum that sucks off all the vapors that are given off from the heat and friction of drilling? And the reason it's critical is that the majority of mercury is inhaled as a gas as it's removed. And the second is, do they provide a supplemental oxygen mask for all of their patients? The oxygen hood should be a very specific cannula-style mask that's inserted into the nose that creates a very special seal around the nose that gives the patient also pure oxygen throughout the procedure to ensure that not only are they not inhaling the mercury vapors, but also that they're just being given pure oxygen to flush their system throughout the procedure. Does your doctor wear a mercury removal mask themselves? You'll see me wearing this very odd looking Darth Vader mask throughout all the procedures. And because mercury removal can be a process that is toxic, I want to ensure that I'm not only protecting my patients, but I'm also protecting myself and my staff from the mercury vapors throughout every procedure. Other things to look for that are critical in a mercury removal dentist are the use of a rubber dam, which is the rubber drape that isolates the tooth specifically of the mercury that's being removed. And this is used to prevent the swallowing of any mercury pieces, particulate matter, or the mercury itself as the filling's being drilled out. And a special suction is going to go over that to ensure that no mercury escapes below the clamp itself. Ask your mercury removal dentist, what materials are they going to replace my mercury filling with? You want to have something that lasts a really long time that's also biocompatible. And unfortunately, most dentists don't know what materials are toxic and which aren't. Here at Moonlight Beach Dental, we only use biocompatible materials that are very enamel-like and that are also pure porcelain and definitely metal free. You also want to make sure that your doctor's walking you through the process. We take a series of intraoral pictures to show you tooth by tooth any damage that might have been done, including cracks or fractures, from the mercury filling that's in your tooth, so that as part of selecting the material that's best for your tooth, I really want the patient actively involved in understanding why we're choosing that material as well. The 10th and final question you want to ask your mercury removal dentist is, are they going to give you anything to aid in the detoxification or chelation of the mercury after it's removed? Again, a doctor doing it safely is going to test your blood levels first and understand how toxic your blood levels are before starting any mercury removal. If you are toxic, the Huggins protocol recommends to use the Quicksilver products that are specialized in removing any mercury that escapes or any existing mercury that's in your system. There are some cofactors and some other supplements that are antioxidants, as well as giving you several extra supplements that'll help boost your immunity and help your clearing of any mercury as it's being removed. We do provide all of those supplements here at the office, and we can give them to you every single visit if needed during your mercury removal process. Not all dentists are the same when it comes to mercury removal. It's not just a matter of drilling out the fillings. And I really am passionate about delivering the safest level of practice to my patients. And it's really important as a patient that you be informed before you have any dental procedure done.